Our next lecture is all about modifying layers. Now we already know what layers are. We've learned how to create layers, rename layers, duplicate layers, reposition layers, color label layers, if you name it, and it's a fact-based thing about layers. We've covered it in a previous chapter. Our new lecture is all about how to create cool modifications for your projects using techniques that modify the layer as a whole or as a group. Our goals for our lecture are to understand what clipping masks are and how they're used for non-destructive editing. We will demonstrate an ability to create and use clipping masks. And I think out of all the things that we're going to cover in today's lecture, the clipping masks are the ones that are going to be the most impactful for you. And you'll see it and say, oh, I think I could use this to create something cool for one of my projects. In addition to the clipping masks, we will experiment with other fun layer techniques, including transformations, content-aware scaling, liquify filters, and warp command. Let's start off with clipping masks. A clipping mask works similarly to a layer mask in the sense that the selected areas of an image are clipped or hidden in a non-destructive way. A key distinction of a clipping mask is that it allows multiple layers to be clipped together at one time within a shape or text. And so if we look at the example on the screen and you don't know what a clipping mask is, you could envision how this may have been created using a layer mask, which is something that we do know, right? On a layer mask, we have a layer and we attach a mask to it. And on the mask, anything that is white, we get to keep, and anything that's black disappears. And so if we look at the Eiffel Tower image that is inside the shape of the letter A, you could kind of picture how there would be a layer that has the picture of the Eiffel Tower, and on that layer I would paint black everything that is outside of the shape of the letter A, and anything on the layer mask that's left white, which would be the shape of the letter A, would allow that to show through in that shape. Now, that would work, and it would be possible, and I could do that over and over again for all the different images that are used in this example here, but it's not the best option if I want to confine the image or multiple images within a shape that might move across the page. When you create a layer mask, your layer mask is for a very specific area of the layer. And if I wanted to take this letter A, where the Eiffel Tower is, and I want to move that A and the rest of the word travel and move it up higher on my screen or on my workspace, I would have to redo my mask over and over again to recreate the look and feel of what I want to create. And so instead of using a layer mask, which would be more difficult in this situation, we'll use a clipping mask. So before we get started with clipping masks, let's talk about key terminology that you must be aware of in order for this to work. And the first is the base layer. It's the bottommost layer upon which the layers above are clipped. And it's incredibly important that you understand that, because when you create your clipping mask, if you do all the steps correctly, but your base layer is wrong, it'll almost appear like nothing happened, or something will happen that you're not intending. And so if you look at my slideshow or my layers panel that I've screenshotted on the right hand side here, you can see that I have three layers that have pictures on it above this travel layer, and you can't see the images, and that's fine, but you should be able to see that it says the word travel. The travel is the base layer of my clipping mask because that is the shape that I wanted the images to clip or go inside of. And when I created the clipping mask for the word travel, I selected the three pictures above the clipping mask. Do not select the clipping mask. And then I did the key command, or I did the process to create a clipping mask, and it clips to whatever the very next layer is. And the very next layer is your base layer. To clip means to limit the areas which are visible or to make temporarily invisible. And so I've added that little "it's temporarily invisible" because it's important to remember that clipping masks are a form of non-destructive editing. I'm simply making the background of these pictures disappear so I can't see them, but if I need to, I could always turn off the clipping mask and I could get back to the original pictures and I could edit them the way that I would edit a normal layer. I don't make you memorize a lot of key commands in the Art 1280 Photoshop class, but this is one that you're going to want to write down because it is the easiest way to create and release clipping masks. And so if you're on a Mac, your key command will be Command Option G, and if you're on a PC, it'll be Control Option G. And so when you're ready to create your clipping masks, you should create them using that key command. Some other fun facts or facts that you should be aware of when creating clipping masks are that layers in a clipping mask will remain fully and independently editable. And so if I decided that I wanted to colorize all the pictures that you're seeing in the word travel, I could go independently to the layer that has the Eiffel Tower and I could apply a filter or I could apply color to it or change it in some way. And I don't have to edit all the pictures or the entire word travel at one time. However, keep in mind that your base layer, if you apply an effect to your base layer, it will be visible on all of your layers. And so in my example here, I've applied layer effects to the word travel to add a bevel and an emboss. And so because I applied it to the base layer, it has been applied visually to all the layers that are contained within the clipping mask. And so I'm going to jump over to Photoshop and I'm going to show you how to create the example that is in the slideshow here or something very similar to it. The steps that I'm going to follow are on the screen here and I'm going to read through them so that you can write them down. So when you're ready to create a clipping mask, you need to line up all the layers that you want to have clipped or you want to have some of those images disappear in some way. You need to stack them on the layers panel so that they're in order and they're consecutive. You can't have any miscellaneous layers in between the first and the last picture, or anything that you select is going to end up being part of the clipping mask. You want to place your base layer at the bottom of those consecutive layers, and so that is whatever the shape or the word or the selection is that you would like the clipping mask to be forced into. In our example, it will be the word travel, but you could use shapes, which we haven't learned how to make yet, but once we learn how to make shapes, you could clip to a shape if you want to. Step three, you're going to select the layers that you want clipped, and you are definitely not going to select that base layer. When you use step four, the key command of Command or Control, Option or Alt G, or if you want to use the menu bars at the top of the screen, you can choose Layer and then Create Clipping Mask. Whatever you have selected, the base layer will become the very next layer. And so if you select your base layer as part of your selection for step three, that will not become the base layer. Whatever is below that on the layers panel will become the base layer. Once you choose layer and then create clipping mask or Command Option G or Control Alt G, your clipping mask will automatically be created and you'll see that your layers are now grouped together with the clipping mask. Then once you have the layers, you can modify them, you can modify your base layer, you can go back to each layer independently and edit those. If you decide that you don't like the clipping mask, you can always release the clipping mask or turn it off. And there's two ways to do that. You could click and drag, and you could drag something out of the clipping mask. And so in my example, I'm going to clip three images into the word travel. If I decide that the first image shouldn't be in there anymore, I can just drag it and drop it somewhere else in the layers panel, and as long as it comes out of the clipping mask, then it won't be part of it. Or you can use the same key command that you use to create the clipping mask to release the clipping mask. And so you can choose Command Option G or Control Option G, or if you like the menu bar, you can go to the layers menu, and then where it used to say Create Clipping Mask, it'll say Release Clipping Mask. And so this is a screenshot of the specific example that you see in the slideshow. And you can see that on the left-hand side, I have stacked the three layers, layers one, two, and three, that have the pictures of, I believe it's a gondola, the Eiffel Tower, and windmills. And I selected them. They're highlighted, so they're lighter gray than the rest of them. Once I have them selected, I made sure that the base layer, the layer that I want the images to clip inside of, and this happens to be a text layer, was below, but it's not selected. And then I went to the layer menu and create clipping mask or that key command, I'll say it again, it is Command Option G or Control Alt G if you're on a PC. And once I did that, you can see that the images are now clipped inside of the word travel. When I look at the example before I started, it may look something like this. It's funky and it's haphazard, it doesn't look right, but the second that I activated my clipping mask, you can see that those images that are taking up the whole screen, they're now nested inside the word travel because that is what the base layer happened to be. So I'm going to jump over to Photoshop and I'm going to show you how to recreate something like this. This is just a similar example that I just created. And so I set up my file and I started designing a poster and I decided that I wanted to have the word travel in my summer vacation. Maybe I'm making a poster or I have to do a presentation in my class for some reason. And I started creating the poster and I really like it. I like the color, together. I have hiccups. But now I decided that I want to put some pictures inside the word travel. And so I I got all of my images, put them all inside the document. I typed all the text that I needed to type, and I'm prepping my file for this clipping mask. Now, if I want to clip the images inside the word travel, right now I cannot select layers 1 through 4 and create a clipping mask because it would clip to the text that says my summer vacation. And so make sure that your base layer is always the very next layer below the images you want to group. And you don't have to do this next step, but I recommend it. It's kind of easier to see what's going on before you clip the text. So right now, if I were to clip the text into the word travel, I would only see this image of the gondola because it's sitting in front of all the other images. And so you may want to choose Edit Free Transform and make the picture smaller. Whoops, I did not mean to do that. Make the picture smaller and sit them in their approximate locations where they may end up being. So I'm just going to repeat Edit Free Transform. Just kind of stack them so that they're not all in the way of each other. And in this example, I guess I have the 4 images, not the 3, the same 3 that were in the original. Okay, so I'm just going to plop them approximately in the location that I want them to be. I'm going to go a little above and beyond, make sure I can't see any of the actual text. And if you want to, you could go above and beyond this step. So you could start to blend the images together. And so you could apply a layer mask to each one of them. And then on the layer mask, you could paint with black, white, or shades of gray in order to, let's make the opacity go down, in order to blend the images together. And so you could, make sure you're on your layer mask when you paint. And so you could try to get the images to blend together a little bit more seamlessly than they currently are. I'm actually a fan of waiting to do this step until after the clipping mask, and I'll show you why in 1 second. Okay, so now that I have the images, they're approximately the right size, it's time to create the clipping mask. And the steps to follow, we've already stacked all the pictures all together that are going to be clipped. I've selected them, and the base layer is the very next layer. And so now we can go to the layer menu and choose Create Clipping Mask. If you're a menus person, that's where you can go. If you're a key commands person, it is Command Option G on a Mac or Control Alt G on a PC. I'm going to hit that right now. And as soon as I do that, it will clip the images to go inside the word travel. And then now we could modify it further. If I decided that I don't like the harsh edge right here, where these buildings in Belgium overlap with the Eiffel Tower, now would be the time to go back and either I could move the picture. Maybe the Eiffel Tower should just be in the letter V, or maybe I decide that it should be in the letter A, like in my previous example, and I reposition these other images accordingly. However you want to do that, now would be the stage to make it look like what you want it to look like. Let me just put those back where they were. Oops, I went too far. But now would be the stage to modify that, make it look like what you wanted it to look like. You could go above and beyond with your clipping mask. Right now, I don't think it looks great because you can't really read the word travel because the background of my poster is not in contrast with the colors in the word travel, especially in the sky. And so you could change the background color. You could change all the images. You could replace them. You could change the colors and the formatting. One really easy way to kind of make the text stand out is to apply layer effects. And so with the base layer selected, if you hit the FX button at the bottom of your layers panel, you could add, in my example, I added a bevel and emboss. And then I have the preview option selected. And so just by default, I haven't done anything. Whatever the last preset was is still saved in there. You can read this much better than you could before. You can go through and you can add like a stroke to the outside. That's probably too big, but you could add a stroke to the outside and change the color. We're going to go through all of the different layer styles and layer effects in detail later in the slideshow. And so I'm not too concerned with that at this point. So I would like you to try to create your own clipping mask before you go back to the next video in the slideshow.